CIET NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So let's join in Dhwani Shala class 6.
Hello my young friends, how are you? I hope you all are safe and healthy at your places. I am your friend Anjali and we are back again with class 6 science chapter 2 components of food. As the topic itself contains the word food, so the overall chapter is going to be interesting and delectable. Before starting this chapter, let me ask you some questions from chapter 1. Why do we need food? We need food to stay healthy. What are the main sources of food? Or from where do we get raw materials for preparing food? Yes, the two main sources of food are plants and animals. Name some food products that are derived from plants, vegetables, fruits, pulses, cereals, etc. Now the next question, what do animals eat? Yes, some animals eat plants, some animals eat other animals, and some animals eat both plants and animals. In the previous chapter, we made list of the food items that we eat. We also identified food items eaten in different parts of India. We saw different varieties of meal and those different varieties of food are eaten by different people. So my dear children, we are usually told and even scolded about not to eat fast food and emphasized to eat healthy food. Have you ever pondered what is this healthy food and why is this so important? This is what we are going to study today. Our meals usually have at least one item made of some kind of grain, and other items could be a dal or a dish of meat and vegetables, or some side dishes, like it may also include items curd, buttermilk and pickles. Sometimes we may not really have all these variety in our meals. For instance, if we are traveling, we may eat whatever is available on the way. It may not be possible for some of us to eat such a variety of items most of the time. There must be some reason though why meals usually consist of such a distribution. Do you think that a body needs different kind of food for some special purpose? We will discuss all these questions, solving your inquisitiveness and get their answers one by one. First of all, let us study about what do different food items contain. Food provides us with some essential material that is needed by the body. We know that each dish is usually made up of one or more ingredients which we get from plants or animals. These ingredients contain some components that are needed for growth, development, and even to protect us from disease. These components are called nutrients. So, what are these nutrients present in our food? The major nutrients in our food are named carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins, and minerals. In addition to them, food also contains dietary fibers and water, which are also needed by our body. Dear children, do you think that all food contains all these nutrients? No, we have already studied different kind of food contain different kind of nutrients. So our diet must include a mixture of these nutrients in order to have a healthy balanced diet. But how can one know which food item contains which nutrient? To know the presence of these nutrients, we have some test. With some simple methods, we can test whether cooked food or raw ingredients contain one or more of these nutrients. The test for the presence of carbohydrates, proteins, and fats are simpler to do as compared to the test for other nutrients. Let us study these tests one by one and we'll look upon the observations. We will begin by testing different food items to see if they contain carbohydrates. There are many types of carbohydrates. The main carbohydrates found in our food are in the form of starch and sugar. To know whether our food contains starch or not, we would perform a test. For doing this test, we will take a food material and add 2-3 drops of dilute iodine solution on it. Students, observe if there is any change in the color of the food item. If it turns blue-black, it indicates that the food contains starch. So, this test is useful to check which food item contains carbohydrate in the form of starch. Repeat this test with other food items to find out which of the raw material or food item contains starch. Now we shall test the presence of proteins. For this test, take a small quantity of food item for testing. For example, we can take pulses because pulses are rich source of proteins, or you can take milk, etc. If the food we want to test is solid, first it is required to grind or mash it to make a powder or paste of it. Put some of this in a clean test tube. For testing, we would need 3 things: solution of copper sulfate, solution of caustic soda, and water. Now add 10 drops of water to the food item and shake the test tube. Now using a dropper, add 2 drops of solution of copper sulfate. And then add 10 drops of solution of caustic soda to the test tube. Shake well and let the test tube stand for a few minutes. What do you see? Did the content of the test tube turn violet? If it turned out, then it indicates the presence of proteins in food content. Now you can repeat this test on other food items. We shall learn how to perform the test for fats. Take a small quantity of a food item, wrap it in a piece of paper and crush it. Take care that the paper does not tear. Now straighten the paper and observe it carefully. Does it have an oily patch? Hold the paper against light or a candle flame for a better observation. Are you able to see the light faintly through this patch? If you observe an oily patch on paper, it shows that the food item contains fat. The food items may sometimes contain a little water. Therefore, after you have rubbed an item on paper, let the paper dry for a while. If there were any water that may have come from food, it would dry up after some time. Therefore, if no oily patch shows up after this, the food item does not contain any fat. You can also perform this test on white cotton cloth, which is easily available. Dear children, we tested food items for 3 nutrients, which are carbohydrates, proteins, and fats. Do all these tests carefully under the supervision of your teacher and do not try to eat or taste any chemicals which are involved in testing these nutrients. Perform these tests on different food items and you will surely get confirmed that several food items contain more than one nutrient, like milk or cooked pulse. Different food items contain varying proportion of these nutrients. There are also some food items that do not contain any of these nutrients. Can you guess some? Yes, fruits, leafy vegetables do not contain any of these nutrients. There are also other nutrients like vitamins and minerals that are present in different food items. Now we will discuss why we need all these nutrients and what do various nutrients do for our body. The energy-giving substances such as sugar and starch contain carbohydrates. Various kinds of sugar include glucose, potable sugar, etc. Starches are obtained from grains, potatoes, peas, corn, etc. Therefore, some sources of carbohydrates in overall are wheat, rice, mango, maize, sugarcane, papaya, millet, etc. Carbohydrates mainly provide energy to our food. Fats also give us energy. In fact, fats give us more energy as compared to the same amount of carbohydrates. Fats are basically of two kinds, that is, animal fats and vegetable oil. Animal fats include substances like butter, ghee, tallow, etc. Vegetable oils include substances produced from seeds, for example, soya bean, sunflower, corn, peanut oil. Food containing fats and carbohydrates are also called energy-giving foods. Now we come to the next nutrient, that is proteins. Proteins are needed for the growth and repair of our body. Foods containing proteins are often called bodybuilding foods because they are important for making bones, skin, muscles, cartilage, and blood. Some plant sources of proteins are gram, soya bean, pulses, peas, whereas paneer, cheese, milk, fish, eggs are some animal sources of proteins. Now we will learn about the necessity of different nutrients, that is vitamins and minerals. Friends, do you know why vitamins and minerals are required for our body? Think? Okay, vitamins and minerals are also essential nutrients of our body. They are required for growth of the body and good health. They boost immunity and help in protecting our body against disease. They help in proper functioning of all the cells of our body and all the body organs. Vitamins also help in keeping our eyes, bones, teeth, and gums healthy. Now let us talk about the types of vitamins. Vitamins are of different kinds known by different names. Some of these are vitamin A, vitamin C, vitamin D, vitamin E, and vitamin K. There is also a group of vitamins called vitamin B complex. Our body needs all these type of vitamins in small quantities. We shall study all of these vitamins one by one. Children, we all know carrots are very good for healthy eyes because carrot contains carotenoids, which are converted into vitamin A by our body. Vitamin A keeps our skin and eyes healthy. Carotenoids are present in green, yellow, orange, and red vegetables, and also in fruits. We also get vitamin A from dairy products like milk, butter, etc. Do you know that deficiency of vitamin A causes night blindness? Eyesight of such people becomes weak and they are not able to see at night. Deficiency of vitamin B may also cause a disease which is called beriberi. Due to this disease, muscles become weak and a person has very little energy to work. The good source of vitamin B are rice, wheat, liver from animals, etc. Next is vitamin C. It helps the body to fight against many diseases. The sources of vitamin C are orange, guava, lemon, amla, green chili, tomato, etc. That is why it is suggested to boost your immunity in this COVID situation specially by having more intake of food material which is rich in vitamin C. Deficiency of vitamin C causes a disease called scurvy. Symptoms for such disease are bleeding gums and wounds take longer time to heal than normal time. Now let us talk about vitamin D. Vitamin D helps our body to absorb calcium and phosphorus for bones and teeth. Deficiency of vitamin D may cause rickets. Tell me, dear children, your elders might have advised you to sit in the sunlight for some minutes. Why do they tell you to do so? Because our body can also make vitamin D in the presence of sunlight. So sunlight is a very good source of vitamin D. Nowadays, insufficient exposure to sunlight is causing vitamin D deficiency in many people. So, give your body sufficient time to sit in the sunlight. Now, next vitamin is vitamin E. It keeps our skin and eyes healthy and it also boosts our immunity. We get vitamin E from vegetable oil, olive oil, dry fruits, etc. Due to deficiency in vitamin E, our muscles and nervous system becomes weak. Now, in the end, we will talk about vitamin K. It helps in clotting of blood. Children, when we are injured and the injured area or wound starts to bleed, our body makes sure bleeding stops soon by forming a blood clot. And which vitamin is responsible for clotting of blood? That is vitamin K. If bleeding doesn't stop for long, it means a body is deficient of vitamin K. So, what are the sources of vitamin K? Pulses, grains, green vegetables, mustard, cabbage, spinach, etc. Vitamin A, D, E, and K are soluble in fats and get deposited in our body. Whereas vitamin B and vitamin C are soluble in water, so they do not get deposited in our body. Children, now let us get some information about minerals and roughage. Just like proteins, minerals are also needed by our body. Each one is essential for proper growth of the body and to maintain good health. Our body cannot make minerals. The requirements of minerals are fulfilled by food that we eat. Minerals are used to keep bones and nervous system healthy. Some minerals make hormones and regulate our heartbeat. Some important minerals are calcium, iron, phosphorus, iodine, chlorine, magnesium, potassium, sodium, and sulfur. Among them, calcium and phosphorus give strength to our teeth, help in blood clotting and contraction of muscles. Some sources of calcium and phosphorus are milk, eggs, pulses, etc. Deficiency of calcium causes bone and tooth decay. The next mineral is iron. Iron helps in the formation of hemoglobin in red blood cells. Iron can be obtained from green vegetables, apple, animal liver, etc. Deficiency of iron causes a disease known as anemia, whose symptoms are weakness in the body. Next mineral is iodine. Iodine helps in proper functioning of thyroid gland. It also helps in growth of the body. We get iodine from green vegetables, iodized salt, ginger, fish, etc. Deficiency of iodine causes disease named goiter. People suffering from this disease lack mental growth or have certain mental illness. They also suffer from swollen neck glands. Children, besides these nutrients, our body needs dietary fibers and water. Dietary fibers are also known as roughage. Roughage is mainly provided by plant products in our food. Whole grains and pulses, potatoes, fresh fruits and vegetables are main sources of roughage. Roughage does not provide any nutrient to our body, but it is an essential component of our food and adds to its bulk. This helps our body get rid of undigested food. If we talk about water, it helps our body to absorb nutrients from food. It also helps in throwing out some waste from the body in the form of urine and sweat. How do we intake water? Normally, we get most of the water that our body needs from the liquid that we drink, such as water, milk, and tea. In addition, we add water while cooking the food also. Children, here comes an activity for the day. Check for resources which provide water to our body. For instance, take a tomato or a fruit like lemon. Cut it into small pieces. Do your hands get wet while doing so? Carefully observe. Whenever vegetables and fruits are being cut, peeled, grated or mashed at your home, do you find any fresh vegetables or fruits that do not contain some amount of water? Note it down and discuss with your teacher. You will conclude after performing this activity that many food materials themselves contain water. To some extent, our body needs are also met by this water. Now, we shall see about balanced diet. The food which we normally eat in a day is our diet. For growth and maintenance of good health, our diet should have all the nutrients that our body needs, and that too in right quantities. Not too much of one and not too little of the other. The diet should also contain a good amount of roughage and water. Such a diet which is containing all essential nutrients is called a balanced diet. Do you think that people of all ages need the same type of diet? Do you also think that what we need for a balanced diet would depend on the physical amount of work that we do? Yes, there are several factors which depend upon the type of diet which we eat and take, like age factor, amount of physical and mental work, etc. Children, here comes another activity for the day. Prepare a chart of whatever you eat over a period of week. Check whether all the nutrients mentioned are present in one or the other food items being eaten within a day or so. You will get to know whether you are having a balanced diet or not. Pulses, groundnut, soya bean, sprouted seeds, fermented food, combination of flours like misi roti, thepla, cereals, pulses, banana, spinach, jaggery, available vegetables and other such foods, they provide many nutrients. Therefore, one can eat a balanced diet without expensive food material. So invest in healthy food items. Eating the right kind of food is not enough. It should also be cooked properly, so that its nutrients are not lost. Are you aware that some nutrients get lost in the process of cooking and preparations? If the vegetables and fruits are washed after cutting or peeling them, it may result in the loss of some vitamins. The skin of many vegetables and fruits contain vitamins and minerals. Similarly, repeated washing of rice and pulses may remove some vitamins and minerals present in them. We all know that cooking improves the taste of food and makes it easier to digest. At the same time, cooking also results in the loss of certain nutrients. Many useful proteins and considerable amount of minerals are lost if excess amount of water is used during cooking and is then thrown away. Vitamin C gets easily destroyed by heat during cooking. Would it not be sensible to include some fruits and raw vegetables in our diet? So that we could get enough amount of vitamins and minerals in the raw form. Think upon this, dear children. Do you think that eating fats would be the best food to eat all the time? As a bowl of fat will give much more energy than a bowl of carbohydrate-rich food, isn't it? Do you think it is right? No, of course not. It can be very harmful for us to eat much of fat-rich foods, and we may end up suffering from a condition called obesity. Now, here comes the last topic for the day. Deficiency disease. A person may be getting enough food to eat, but sometimes the food may not contain a particular nutrient. If this continues over a long period of time, the person may suffer from its deficiency. Deficiency of one or more nutrients can cause disease or disorders in our body. Disease that occur due to lack of nutrients over a long period are called deficiency disease. If a person does not get enough proteins in his or her food for a longer time, then he or she is likely to have stunted growth, swelling of face, discoloration of hair, skin disease, and diarrhea. If the diet is deficient in both carbohydrates and proteins for a longer period of time, the growth may stop completely. Such a person becomes very lean and thin and so weak that he or she may not be able to move. We have already discussed the deficiency of different vitamins and minerals. So, my dear friends, please remember, all deficiency disease can be prevented by taking a balanced diet. So, my dear children, today we learned why it is important to ensure that our meals have a balance of the different nutrients needed by the body. Thank you.
You are just listening to curriculum-based programs, Dhwani Shala. Production assistants, Meenakshi Kukreti and Tanu Gupta. This program was recorded by Bati Langlingdo and technically assisted by Soumya Malik. Produced by Ajit Horo. This program was brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.